This is Pilgrim Church. This is the table that is set for everyone. It doesn't matter how many times you've come into this sanctuary. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter if you are a member of Pilgrim or a member of some other congregation or a member of no church at all. It doesn't matter if you claim a faith. It doesn't matter if you woke up this morning angry as can be. It doesn't matter if you didn't get enough sleep. It doesn't matter if you're filled with joy. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you are here. Each of you is in this place. You stepped through those doors, or perhaps those doors, but you are here. You make up the faith community this day. Everyone who is here is welcome to the table. And for those of you who might be playing music throughout, we will make sure you receive the elements if you wish. If you can't come forward, we will make sure you receive the elements if you wish them. You are welcome to the table. You are not required at the table. No matter whether you take communion here or not, know that you are beloved. Let us pray. Holy God, we come inspired by your Spirit to move from tension to reconciliation, from pain to healing, from chaos to peace, from death to love. As we follow the life and ministry of Jesus, we are reminded of your willingness to call and lead and forgive. We are reminded of the ways we have participated in systems and individual behaviors that have alienated and marginalized God's beloved people. We open our lives to being changed. We open our hearts to being softened. We open our beings to the movement of the Spirit within us and among us. We are open to being transformed. We are grateful, Holy One, for your continued faithfulness even to the unfaithful. We are grateful for your willingness to forgive and recommit. We are grateful for your forgiveness of our own unfaithfulness. We celebrate this meal that reminds us again and again that no matter who we are or where we are on life's journey, we are welcome at your table. And for this, Holy One, we are deeply grateful. We remember that on the night of his betrayal and desertion and on the eve of his torture and execution, Jesus gathered with those who followed him. He took bread. He gave thanks to God for these gifts. He blessed the bread. He broke the bread. And he gave it to those who were at the table, everyone who was at the table. And he said, "Take and eat. This is the bread of life. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, following the meal, Jesus took the cup, he blessed it, and he gave it to those who were gathered with him, and he said, "This is the cup of the new covenant." You know the new covenant, right? You know the commitment you make, right? To love one another. Maybe not like one another, but to deeply, truly love one another, to do what is in the best interest of all, rather than in your own self-interest, to love one another. He gave it to those gathered at the table and said, do this in remembrance of me. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Come, for all is ready.
Thank you. Warrior.